हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द कमर्शियल सेल्स और बैटरीज। नॉर्मली इन एंट्रेंस एग्जामिनेशन यू गेट क्वेश्चन अबाउट सिंपल रिएक्शंस अकरिंग एट एनोड और कैथोड इन डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ सेल्स और बैटरीज और कैन टेक फॉर डिफरेंट बैटरीज देयर एप्लीकेशन मींस यूजेस और द ड्रॉबैक्स। तो इन द गिवन टॉपिक वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट दिस कमर्शियल सेल्स और बैटरीज which are used almost every time by us in our daily life as well. We are using watches, mobiles, calculators, computers, in home, cars, almost everywhere we are using this batteries. So let us say battery basically when you take commercial cells or batteries, battery basically are using the chemical redox reactions which is helping to produce electrical energy. In the battery they involve redox reactions. That redox reaction is spontaneous, involving flow of electrons. That flow of electron we use for generation of the electrical current. So basically they are involving the galvanic cell or voltaic cells or electrochemical cells for this purpose of generation of the electrical energy from chemical reactions. Now all the electrochemical cells cannot be used for generation of electrical energy or in batteries. Like I have given the basic inputs here, when you take batteries are basically electrochemical cells. Batteries are basically electrochemical cells or galvanic cells which generate electrical energy by chemical redox reactions which are spontaneous. But each and every electrochemical cell cannot be used as battery or commercial cells. Why? Because of these two reasons. There are two main reasons because of which we cannot use batteries for commercial purpose. All electrochemical cells cannot be used for commercial purpose. हमारे क्या दो drawback आते हैं? पहला क्या है? If you take already we have seen the working of electrochemical cells. What they involve? They have salt bridge. We take one anodic compartment, one cathodic compartment. They are using salt bridge. The salt bridge have high internal resistance. That the salt bridge have high internal resistance. So what will happen? So whenever from the cell we want to withdraw more current, the voltage will decrease sharply. That is one of the main drawback that we cannot use all cells which are having salt bridge for the purpose of commercial batteries or cells preparations. क्यों? पहला point क्या हुआ कि they use salt bridge which has applicable point को मैं दिखते रहिए आप लोग. They have salt bridge or use salt bridge which has high internal resistance. So if we try to draw large current, their voltage will drop sharply. That is one drawback. Second drawback taken there, they lack compactness. मतलब उसको हमें compactness and ruggedness. Ruggedness का होता है rough handling. अब battery का होता है आप घर ले जाते कई बार mobile पे ऐसे डाल दिया, watch अपने का छोड़ दी कहीं पे भी, कई बार गिर जाती है mobile, कई बार गिरता है, ठीक है ना? तो क्या होता है गिरने से क्या होता है कुछ फर्क पड़ना नहीं चाहिए. इफ यू टेक इलेक्ट्रोकेमिकल सेल्स गैल्वेनिक सेल छोड़ दो क्या होगा फूट जाएगा. तो क्या करेंगे इसमें हमने क्या बोला दे लैक कॉम्पैक्टनेस इन स्मॉल स्पेस दे शुड हैव कॉम्पैक्ट स्पेस इन व्हिच वी कैन पुट देम एंड रगडनेस वन टर्म वी आर यूजिंग रगडनेस मींस होता है रफ हैंडलिंग कि ट्रांसपोर्टेशन करना है आपका पोर्टेबिलिटी करनी है बैटरीज का तो क्या होना चाहिए दे शुड नॉट हैव एनी डिस्टर्बेंस और नथिंग शुड हैपन इन देयर फंक्शनिंग. That is meaning ruggedness. So we have many cells which are lacking compactness and ruggedness, especially for portability purpose. For these two main issues or reasons, all electrochemical cells will not be suitable for this commercial purpose. So when we think about this cells or electrochemical cell to be used for this commercial purpose, the two drawbacks should be mainly overcome. कैसे कैसे आपका पहला क्या है क्या लिखा है फॉर इलेक्ट्रोकेमिकल सेल टू बी यूज्ड एज कमर्शियल सेल दे शुड फुलफिल द टू रिक्वायरमेंट्स. आप ये लिखते रहो सारा बिकॉज आपको इतना ही पढ़ना है इसके बारे में एंड दैट इज सफिशिएंट फॉर एग्जामिनेशंस. क्या है पहला पॉइंट दे शुड हैव कॉम्पैक्टनेस स्मॉल स्पेस दे शुड बी कंसंट्रेटेड दे शुड हैव रगडनेस इन ट्रांसपोर्टेशन पोर्टेबिलिटी दे शुड हैव नो इंपैक्ट लाइटनेस लाइट होना चाहिए इसका वेट यहां पर and should have long life as well. अगला पॉइंट क्या है when we are using the batteries, the voltage should not drop sharply. During use, the voltage of such cells should not drop sharply in their use. तो ये हमारे दो requirements हैं. अगर fulfill होंगे, then the batteries all can take electrochemical cells. We can use for the commercial purpose. And we are studying here three types of cells. We will study here three types of cells. कौन से cell पढ़ेंगे? पहला होता है primary cell. I'll just explain here. So today working here of commercial cells or batteries, we will use three types of cells. Which are in our syllabus. First can be taken primary cells. Primary cells. What are primary cells? Basically, we are using primary cells only once. The redox reaction will occur in the primary cell only once. And after the reaction is over, the battery becomes dead. It cannot generate more electrical energy. It cannot supply current for more duration after or once the battery is dead. So what happens? They have redox reaction occurring only once in the primary cells. They cannot be recharged. Like we have several cells, we cannot recharge them. So that the primary cells basically, they will not be recharged. Or we cannot recharge them. So we will study two types of cells in our syllabus in primary cells. One taken is dry cell. We will take the working pattern of cells. Second taken called as mercury cell. Mercury cell. We will syllabus our dry cells and mercury cell. And second taken then here, secondary cells. What are secondary cells? In secondary cells, they are basically rechargeable. They are rechargeable. And they can function as both electrolytic cell and electrochemical cells. They can act as both electrolytic cell and galvanic cell. Means kya hota hai? Ke from outside, when we supply electrical energy, aapko ye point dhyan hoga, when we were teaching you about electrochemical cells or galvanic cell, I told, when from outside, if we supply voltage more than the cell voltage, cell's electromotive force, then the cell reaction will be reverse. Aapko yaad hoga galvanic cell mein, in galvanic cell, what is cell voltage? E naught cell, we told 1.10 volt. If from outside we supply voltage lower than 1.1, even then reaction keep on occurring in the forward direction, means zinc oxidized to give zinc plus 2 ion, CO plus 2 ion reduced to copper metal, but reaction slows down. Now if from outside we apply voltage equal to the cell voltage 1.1 volt, then the reaction stop. We can say reaction come to point of equilibrium. Reaction cannot happen in any direction. And now when the voltage exceeds 1.1 volt, then what happen? The reaction will reverse. Electrochemical cell will start functioning as electrolytic cell. The galvanic cell start functioning as electrolytic cell. From outside we supply volt electric current. So their copper get oxidized and zinc plus 2 ion will get reduced. The reaction will occur in the backward direction. Same thing happen in the secondary cells. From outside when we supply electrical energy, they undergo recharging. They undergo recharging, then they act as electrolytic cell. And once we are using them, from the battery we are withdrawing current, then they will act as galvanic cell or electrochemical cell, where by chemical redox reaction, which are spontaneous, they supply to us electrical energy. They produce electrical energy by the spontaneous redox reaction. So we will study what happened. More thing, in the given secondary cells, they generate some solids, electrolytes, solids compounds which remain on the electrodes. They stick on the electrodes so that the direction of reaction can be reversed at any time. We will explain about this in details when I take the working of cells. So in our syllabus, we will have two kind of cells in secondary cells. One we will study about lead storage battery, and second will be taken about, one is lead studded battery, second nickel cadmium battery, nickel cadmium cell, called also Nicard cell, nickel cadmium cell. So that is secondary cells. We will study about their working, functioning, drawbacks also. Third aata hai isme fuel cells. Fuel cells. What happens in fuel cells? They convert the heat of combustion, the enthalpy of combustion into electrical energy. These fuel cells convert the enthalpy of combustion into electrical energy. Because we know combustion reaction are redox reactions. Combustion reactions are redox reactions. So we take combustion reaction of hydrogen or CO or methane by different fuels. When the fuels undergo combustion, the second reactant is understood oxygen. So we can have H2O2 fuel cell, COO2 fuel cell, CH4O2 fuel cells. Means the fuel undergo combustion, and then combustion, which is a combustion reaction, which is a redox reaction. That redox reaction involve electrons exchange. They produce or convert the enthalpy of combustion. Fuel pe kya hota hai? Combustion. Combustion kya hai? Redox reaction. So these fuel cells convert the enthalpy of combustion directly into electrical energy. These fuel cells convert the enthalpy of combustion into electrical energy. Okay. So in this case, we will study mainly about your fuel cells. Hydrogen O2 fuel cell. We study about your hydrogen H2O2 fuel cell. This fuel cells are finding specific high uses, especially when we require to use them without pollution. And moreover, in these fuel cells, they are used where? In spacecraft. Because in suppose this H2O2 fuel cell, kya hota hai isme? Combustion reaction hoga and they produce water. Water can be used in drinking purpose in the spacecraft, and they are lighter and they have very high efficiency. If you take in the fuel cells, they have normally efficiency of conversion of heat energy to electric energy around more than 60%. It can go up to 70% or more. But if you take the combustion of coal in thermal power plant, they rarely reach the thermal, they rarely reach the efficiency of around 40%. Meaning a lot of energy is wasted. Kyun? Pehle combustion hota coal ka, kya banayega? CO, CO2 gases. In the combustion reaction, they produce heat. That heat is used to evaporate water for generation of steam. That steam will help in rotating the turbines, which can produce electrical energy. So what happened? There is energy wastage, and the thermal power plants, they rarely reaches, or they have efficiency in general around 40%. Whereas fuel cells, they have an efficiency around or more than even 70%. Average taken, 60 to 70% of heat of combustion will convert to electrical energy in the fuel cell. So they are quite useful in that respect. Now we will take the working of these cells one by one. First we take primary cells. In the primary cell, first we take working of dry cell. आपको पढ़ना क्या सारे cells में क्या आपके लिए important है questions मैं पूछने के लिए पहले पूछते हैं batteries का basically reactions क्या होंगे, anode पर reaction क्या है, cathode पर reaction क्या है, बैटरी में क्या एडवांटेज है उसके और क्या उसके डिसएडवांटेज हैं, आपको ये देखना है इसमें, और इसका डिस्पोजल के प्रॉब्लम होते हैं कुछ बैटरीज का, वो आपको देखना है इसमें है, वोल्टेज कितना तक ड्रॉ कर सकते हैं, उसका लाइफ कितना है. तो देयर डिफरेंट सूटेबिलिटी वी डिसाइड ऑफ द बैटरीज, कितना करंट चाहिए उससे अकॉर्डिंग हम बैटरीज करते हैं. तो वी कैन यूज अ डिफरेंट सेल्स एज पर द रिक्वायरमेंट, कि वी रिक्वायर लो वोल्टेज हाई करंट. तो इन दैट केस we will use different batteries. So in the given batteries, first we will take here is primary cells, and in the primary cell, first cell will be taken here a dry cell. Okay, so let us take next topic, dry cell. So let us take our primary cell. Example is taken in the primary cell, dry cell. Already I told you in primary cell or dry primary cells, redox reaction occur only once. they are not rechargeable. We cannot reuse them after they are dead.
So what the basic diagram I drawn for a dry cell?
Dry cell आप जो देखते हैं use करते हैं like in टॉर्च फ्लैश लाइट जो हम यूज करते हैं बैटरीज होते हैं बड़े बड़े बैटरीज आप मिडल होते हैं साइज के और वी यूज इन वॉल क्लॉक्स और वी आर यूजिंग वेयर दिस ड्राई सेल्स इन दैट मेली फ्लैश लाइट और रेडियोस एटसेट्रा
तो दोज बैटरीज व्हेन वी आर यूजिंग ड्राई सेल्स वन सिंपल डायग्राम इज स्पेसिफाइड हियर ऑफ ए प्राइमरी सेल और ड्राई सेल एग्जांपल इन द ड्राई सेल व्हाट हैपेंस The anode is cylindrical zinc vessel. We take a cup, zinc cup,
zinc vessel or zinc container
that is acting as
cylindrical shape.
That zinc vessel is acting as
anode.
Anode is given negative sign.
At anode, they produce electrons by the reaction,
and then we can take. We have in the center a graphite rod. Graphite rod in center. This graphite rod is not touching the base. This basically entire vessel is made of zinc cup, zinc vessel. So the base, graphite rod is not touching the base. And then at the top they have metal cap. It is sealed by pitch seal taken here. And this zinc vessel we have on the zinc vessel cardboard cover.
आपने बैटरी को भी देखा होगा उसमें देखा कवरिंग
ऑन द बैटरीज व्हाई टू प्रोटेक्ट इट फ्रॉम एटमॉस्फेयर लिखा इसमें स्पेस बिटवीन द यू कैन टेक दिस कैथोड ग्रेफाइट रॉड एंड द जिंक वेसल इज फिल्ड बाय द पेस्ट ऑफ ZnCl2 एंड NH4Cl जस्ट अराउंड ग्रेफाइट वी ट्राई टू हैव हायर कंसंट्रेशन ऑफ मैंगनीज डाइऑक्साइड एंड कार्बन ब्लैक पोरस मटेरियल सो Around that we have this entire vessel is filled by the paste of ZnCl2 and NH4Cl. We are filling by the paste of ZnCl2 and NH4Cl. The space between the anode, आप लिखते रहो सारे points को है. Space between anode and cathode is filled with paste of ZnCl2 and NH4Cl, touching the zinc vessel. Whereas MnO2 and carbon black powder form, they are touching the graphite rod in center. Now what happens? The zinc container or vessel is covered with a cardboard to protect it from atmosphere. You know, zinc have very low inert RP, -0.76 volt. So to protect the zinc from action of atmosphere, we are covering the zinc vessel or container with a cardboard. Okay. Now what are reactions? And around the in the given battery, there are several complex reactions. The reaction are written here in simplified form. Like zinc vessel will dissolve to give zinc plus 2 ions producing electrons at anode हमारा reactions common सारे जगह पर रहते हैं अगर हम बोलते हैं anode पे क्या reaction होता है oxidation यहाँ भी same है at anode oxidation reaction will take place what happens at cathode reduction reaction reduction किसका हुआ MnO2 का through carbon form तो इसमें क्या है MnO2 plus ammonium ions plus 2 electron give Mn2O3 Manganese have oxidation number +4 will convert to manganese in +3 oxidation number by gain of electrons and liberating ammonia gas in water. If we add both reactions, it is net reaction. Zinc get oxidized to zinc plus 2 ions. MnO2 get reduced from Mn2O3. Ammonium ions will give ammonia and water. O will come from MnO2. So that is what happening in the net reaction in the dry cell. Now what happens is ammonia produce. इसका बैटरी में क्या कुछ पॉइंट्स ध्यान रखेंगे क्या क्या पॉइंट्स होंगे इन द रिएक्शन फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल दिस अमोनिया गैस इज प्रोड्यूस इट डज नॉट एस्केप टू एटमोस्फियर इन द रिएक्शन अमोनिया गैस प्रोड्यूस डज नॉट एस्केप टू एटमोस्फियर बट दिस अमोनिया विल कंबाइन विद ZnCl2 इन द पेस्ट Ammonia plus ZnCl2 to form soluble complex in the same paste ZnNH3O4Cl2. Ammonia gas in the reaction produced will not escape out, but ammonia will combine with the ZnCl2 and form this complex. So ammonia will not escape out. पॉइंट नंबर वन अब हम रखेंगे इसमें।
अगला पॉइंट इसमें क्या आता है, विद दिस बैटरी दे प्रोवाइड ए वोल्टेज अराउंड 1.25, दे प्रोवाइड द वोल्टेज ऑफ अराउंड 1.25 to 1.5 वोल्टेज। They provide the voltage of 1.25 to 1.50. That voltage is produced from the given battery during its use. That is second point. And these batteries are not. इसका main drawback सबसे बड़ा क्या होता है कि these batteries have not long life. They are short life. इसका सबसे बड़ा drawback यही था batteries का कि they have very short life. Even when the battery is not used, it can become dead. Even when the battery is not used. It can become dead. क्यों? It contains the paste which has NH4Cl. You know from chapter ionic equilibrium, salt NH4Cl is acidic in nature. It is a salt of strong acid HCl and weak base ammonium hydroxide or ammonia. So salt is acidic in nature. It can dissolve the vessel. It can dissolve the vessel slowly. तो इवन इफ यू कीप द बैटरी के नया बैटरी रखा हुआ है लीव फॉर सम मोर ड्यूरेशन बैटरी बिकम डेड। क्यों? बिकॉज द जडन्स NH4Cl इन द बैटरी विल डिजॉल्व द जिंक वेसल स्लोली इवन व्हेन द बैटरी इज नॉट इन यूज। सो इसका सबसे बड़ा ड्रॉबैक ये होता है कि दिस बैटरीज आर हैविंग शॉर्ट लाइफ नॉट लॉन्ग लाइफ। आई होप दिस इज क्लियर इन बैटरी का आपका ड्रॉबैक और इसका advantage. Advantage is that they can supply good enough voltage for the time they are used. Okay? It is about your dry cell. First example in primary cells. Now second cell will be taken about here is mercury cell. Okay? So let us take mercury cell now. So let us say second cell taken is primary cells. Example is mercury cell. In the mercury cell where we are using mercury cells, they are also called button cells. They are very small in size. आपने कभी देखा होगा घर में like in watches, calculator sometime, hearing aids, small electrical devices in which it is difficult to put bigger batteries, we are putting mercury cells. They are used in small electrical devices such as example taken like hearing aids, watches or calculators, we are using these batteries. What is in batteries? Zinc container is acting as anode. It is a complex type diagram. In your books can see the diagram. I'm just writing simplified manner because for you the reactions and the battery's application are important. So what is anode? Zinc container is acting as anode. Cathode is carbon rod. Carbon rod is acting as cathode. What is electrolyte? They have electrolyte moist mercury oxide mixed with KOH filled between the two electrodes. Is acting as electrolyte. So electrolyte is mercury oxide plus KOH. Then a lining of porous paper. First separation. A lining of porous paper keep electrolyte separated from the zinc anode. What is reactions now at anode and cathode? Now reactions are important for you to understand. At anode oxidation reaction occur of zinc to give zinc oxide plus water and oxidation lose two electrons. Reduction occur of mercury ions to form mercury metal liquid form plus 2 OH negative ion. Now what is net reaction involved here? If you take net reaction and you write here, it can be taken Zn zinc amalgam plus HgO solid. If you take water in the net reaction cancels out, so is OH negative in the net reaction cancel out, electrons in the net reaction cancel out. What we have product side? ZnO solid plus Hg liquid. If you take net reaction on both sides, they don't involve any ion. This point is very important. कि आपका जो net reaction यहाँ पर हो रहा है, उसमें कोई भी ion involved नहीं है. इसका advantage क्या है? अगर net reaction में कोई ions involved नहीं है, तो क्या होता है? उसका concentration vary नहीं करता है. Net reaction does not involve any ion whose concentration can vary, change, whose concentration can change or vary with time. So what happened? This point find application of use that this battery can provide a constant voltage. It can provide a constant voltage
of around 1.35 volt throughout its life.
You can just recall, in the dry cell we were having the electrolyte, that NH4Cl was reacting with the zinc vessel. That drawback is not there. These batteries can provide a longer life, and in the longer life they provide a constant voltage of 1.35 volt. तो इसके दो एडवांटेज हुए कि एक तो क्या हुआ इसका मेन पॉइंट के नेट रिएक्शन डज नॉट इन्वॉल्व एनी आयन हुज कंसंट्रेशन कैन चेंज विद टाइम सो दे कैन प्रोवाइड ए कांस्टेंट वोल्टेज ऑफ नियरली 1.35 वोल्ट और कम है ड्राई सेल से बट रिजल्ट इज बेटर एंड थ्रू आउट इट्स लाइफ पहला पॉइंट देन इसका व्हाट इज मेन ड्रॉबैक इनका ड्रॉबैक आता है मर्करी कंपाउंड्स आर We can take natural hazards, they are poisonous in nature. Mercury compounds are poisonous, mercury itself is poison. So what happens is mercury compounds, poisonous in nature, make difficult the disposal of these batteries. Disposal when they release, suppose, and leakage of mercury, in any case, will cause loss in terms of its poisonous nature. That's the main drawback of these batteries. Iska application kahan par hota hai? Iska main application aapka hai? In watches, hearing aids or small electrical devices. Okay, so it is about your mercury cell. One more example taken of the primary cell. Now let us take secondary cells examples. In secondary cells, we will take two main cells. One is called lead storage battery and second is taken nickel cadmium battery, NiCad battery. So let us take the working of secondary cells now. So let us now come on the secondary cells. One example, we will take two cells here. One is lead storage battery and second is nickel cadmium battery. So let us first take the working of lead storage battery. What happens if you take arrangement or structure wise? When the battery, if you see practical, that you go to some shop, electrical shop, where the work is going on batteries, you can see after cut off that what the battery contains. They are actually made of lead grid. Actually, there are assemblies there of lead grids containing spongy lead. We call them lead plates. The lead grids are there. We take many sheets, bunches of lead grid which contain spongy lead filled in them. And then they are acting as anode. Spongy lead is filled in the lead plates or lead grid. That is acting as anode. And we take again lead grids containing powdered PbO2 filled in them. Lead grids containing powdered PbO2 filled in them. That is acting as cathode. And we are taking solution of dilute sulfuric acid as electrolyte. When the battery is fully charged, then the concentration of acid is nearly 38% by mass. When the battery is charged, it have concentration of sulfuric acid around 38% by weight and solution of density nearly 1.3 gram per cc. So it is the simple arrangement I try to show for your understanding purpose only. If we take bunches of lead sheets or lead grid containing spongy lead filled in them, that will act as anode. We take assemblies connected here. Normally we connect around 6 cells to make up one battery. And then again we take lead grids containing powdered PbO2 filled in them. PbO2 will act as cathode in the given battery. So let us say reactions when the battery will be used. Dekhi, this battery or in general secondary cells, they are rechargeable. They are rechargeable means we can use them again and again. Once they are used, they get discharged. Again by recharging, the cell reactions are reversed and then the battery you can use again. We are using these batteries most commonly. In your like, you can take house. When the current is coming, light is coming, what happens? The battery will be undergoing recharging. So that when the light goes, current goes, what happens? The battery will act as electrochemical cell and then the battery will produce electrical current, electric energy. That is helping that help in running the electrical devices. आपका एग्जाम टाइम पढ़ना होता है, एग्जाम का टाइम पढ़ना होता है, तो लाइट कहाँ से आएगा? अगर लाइट चला जाता है, स्पेशली अगर आपके प्लेस पर लाइट कट होता है, पावर कट होता है, तो नॉर्मली यू हैव पावर बैकअप। क्या होता है इसमें, वी टेक वन इन्वर्टर एंड वी टेक बैटरीज, असेंबलीज आर टेकन टू कन्वर्ट द एसी टू डीसी और वाइस वर्सा। नाउ व्हाट हैपन व्हेन द दिस सेल विल एक्ट एज बोथ इलेक्ट्रोलाइटिक सेल एंड इलेक्ट्रोकेमिकल सेल। When the battery is undergoing chemical redox reaction spontaneous, it supply electrical energy, then they are acting as galvanic cell or electrochemical cell. And when the battery is discharged, it need recharging, so what happened during recharging? During recharging, the battery will act as electrolytic cell. From outside, we are supplying electrical energy that help in chemical redox reaction. So electric energy will convert to chemical energy during recharging. During discharging, it is acting as galvanic cell. Due to chemical reaction, it produce electric energy. That's the functioning of all secondary cells. One point more, I'll show you. Let's see reaction. What reactions happen at anode and cathode? If you take anode reaction, lead solid oxidized to give lead sulfate PbSO4. In presence of sulfuric acid, give PbSO4 solid plus 2H plus ions plus 2 electrons. At anode, oxidation reaction take place. At cathode, reduction reaction occur, where in reduction reaction PbO2 solid plus 2 plus sulfuric acid aqueous plus 2H plus ions plus 2 electrons will form PbSO4 solid plus 2H2O liquid. To add both reactions, what we get? Net cell reaction. At anode, what happened during discharging? That the reaction during discharging, the battery will supply electric energy, Pb solid oxidized to lead sulfate, giving electrons. In presence of sulfuric acid as electrolyte, PbO2 also oxidized, PbO2 reduced. Lead have plus 4 oxidation number, will form lead plus 2 oxidation number. If you just add both reactions, what is net cell reaction? Pb solid plus PbO2 solid plus 2 moles of sulfuric acid aqueous. This can be written as 4 hydrogen plus ions plus sulfate ion as well. I'm just writing simplified way. 2 PbSO4 solid plus 2 H2O liquid. If you see the net reaction, in the net reaction what happened? At anode and cathode, both electrode they produce lead sulfate solid. This lead sulfate will not go in solution. It accumulate on the electrodes. It is the requirement for the secondary cells. If they produce some substances, solid substances, which should not go in solution, but they remain stick on the electrodes, so that at any time direction of reaction can be reversed. So PbSO4 is produced solid, will not go in solution and settle down at the bottom. It remain on the electrodes. Remember, it remains on the electrodes. So that if the reaction is to occur in backward direction, suppose from outside we supply electric energy, so reaction will be reverse reaction. In the backward direction, this will be reduced, this is oxidized. So backward direction or backward reaction will take place. Now for backward reaction, we again require lead sulfate. If it is not in contact with the electrodes, reaction becomes difficult. So it is requirement that they should form some salts which are remaining on the electrodes respectively. So this lead sulfate will remain on the electrode when it is produced during discharging. Now further see the net reaction. Pb solid, PbO2 solid. Solution have two only components. One is sulfuric acid, second is water. In the reaction. So in this case, when the battery will be used up, what is molar weight of this sulfuric acid? 98 gram. It has molar weight 98 gram. When reaction takes place, they form water, which has molar weight 18 gram per mole. Acid has molar weight 98 gram per mole. So whenever the question they ask you, okay, for how much duration the battery have been consumed, like for how many ampere hours battery have been used, what is the meaning of ampere hour? If you draw a current of 1 ampere per second, then in 1 hour they can withdraw how much current? 3600 coulombs. A charge equivalent to 3600 coulombs can be taken as 1 ampere hour. Possessing a current, withdrawing a current of 1 ampere for 1 hour, how much charge will be withdrawn from the battery? That is called ampere hour. So they ask sometime, okay, for how many ampere hour battery have been consumed, or find number of Faradays consumed, used up, withdrawn from the battery. So in that kind of question, to find the amount only, we can take this compound's amount only. What data in the question is supplied, the data will be given before use. What happens? Solution is containing dilute solution of H2SO4S electrolyte, which contains 38% by weight, and for solution density is 1.3 gram per cc. Listen this point very carefully. This is very important. When the battery will be used, what do you think about the weight of solution? Or for solution density, the weight of solution will decrease, because iska molar weight hai 98, iska molar weight hai 18. Jab reaction hoga to iska amount consume kam ho raha hai. Amount kam hone ka meaning kya hai? Iska molar weight 98 hai aur iska kitna molar weight hai? Just 18. So 98 gram of substance in solution give only 18 gram water, so the weight of solution decrease. Even if volume supposed to remain almost constant, then the density of solution will decrease. Normally when the battery's solution density reaches around 1.2 gram per cc, the battery need recharging. It need recharge or recharging. So the battery will have density dropping around 1.2 gram per cc, it require recharging. So is battery ka ye aapka kya hota hai? Indication ki current will be lower. Now for calculation, again coming on calculation part, I hope ye point aapko samajh mein aa raha hoga ki iska molar weight zyada hai, iska molar weight kam hai. Jab reaction hoga to total weight zyada hai, kam weight banega solution mein, to weight of solution kam hoga. What is density? Weight by volume. So weight kam hoga to kya hoga? Solution density kam hoga. When the battery will be used up, the density of solution decreases, because the weight of solution will decrease as well. Ab question by finding number of Faradays, we told you some Faradays laws based question. Number of Faradays in this case can be taken same as gram equivalent of sulfuric acid used. Aur ye kitna hota hai? It is weight upon equivalent weight. What is equivalent weight? Molar weight is 98 by n factor. Can you tell in the reaction what is n factor value of sulfuric acid? ये point ऐसा है कि बच्चे गलती करते हैं इसमें. इसमें कितना n factor आना चाहिए इस acid के लिए? Can you tell? 2? No. इसका n factor 1 रहता है. 1 क्यों रहता है? देखिए आपका जब reaction हुआ, in the net reaction they involve how many electrons? 2 electrons. आपका oxidation हुआ तब electron 2 का loss हुआ. Reduction में 2 electron का gain हुआ. When oxidation or reduction reaction take place, they exchange 2 moles of electrons. They exchange 2 moles of electrons lost in oxidation or gain in reduction. For how many moles involved in the net reaction? 2 moles. इसका खुद का यहाँ पर oxidation reduction नहीं हो रहा है, but इसके terms में हम निकालेंगे number of Faradays. इसका खुद का oxidation या reduction नहीं हुआ यहाँ पर, बट इसके टर्म्स में ही आपको निकालना है नंबर ऑफ फैराडेस. तो हम क्या करते हैं, इसका फैक्टर क्या लगेगा यहां पर? 1. क्यों? 2 मोल्स के लिए हमारे 2 इलेक्ट्रॉन कंज्यूम हुए, तो 1 मोल के लिए कितना इलेक्ट्रॉन कंज्यूम होगा? 1 मोल इलेक्ट्रॉन. इसलिए इस कंपाउंड का एन फैक्टर यहां पर 1 लेते हैं. इसको ध्यान रख लीजिए, ये पॉइंट बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है. अगर आप यहां पर एन फैक्टर 2 ले लेंगे, आप सोचोगे डाइप्रोटिक Yes, so inflator 2, no. My dear students, inflator ka 1 rahega. Isko aap dhyan se note kar lijiye, theek hai? To inflator kitna hua aapka 1 ho jayega. To kya hua? Agar aapka inflator 1 hai, to kya hua? Same as moles of acid pendulums. So in this case, number of Faradays will be same as moles of sulfuric acid used. आप इस पॉइंट को ध्यान रखेंगे. ये हमारा रिएक्शन करता है ड्यूरिंग डिस्चार्जिंग. व्हेन द बैटरी इज सप्लाइंग इलेक्ट्रिकल एनर्जी ड्यू टू दिस केमिकल रेडॉक्स रिएक्शन व्हिच इज स्पॉन्टेनियस इन दैट केस. इफ इट इज अंडरगोइंग डिस्चार्जिंग ड्यूरिंग रिचार्जिंग आपका दोनों रिएक्शन क्या करोगे? रिवर्स कर देंगे. ठीक है, दैट इज वर्किंग ऑफ द लेड स्टोरेज बैटरी. इस पॉइंट पे बेस कुछ क्वेश्चन मार्क कराएंगे. तो बेटा कितना ध्यान रखिए फिलहाल टाइमिंग के लिए कि इस कंपाउंड का इफेक्टर 1 रहेगा. अमाउंट निकालना इजी है कि आफ्टर यूज देगा कि इतना बैटरी में सॉल्यूशन में एसिड का अमाउंट बचा हुआ है, इतना परसेंटेज का वेट है और इस सॉल्यूशन का डेंसिटी दिया हुआ है, तो कितना डिफरेंस आएगा वेट. हाउ टू फाइंड वेट, वॉल्यूम इनटू डेंसिटी इज वेट ऑफ सॉल्यूशन. कितना परसेंटेज निकालोगे फिर इसका अमाउंट निकालेंगे. डिफरेंस इज द वेट ऑफ एसिड यूज्ड बाय मोलर वेट 98 मोल्स दे देगा. Since inflator 1 है, तो moles will be same as number of Faradays used in the battery in the given time interval. Okay? So it is about working and functioning of your lead storage battery. अब आगे चलते हैं. Next आएगा इसमें nickel cadmium battery. So let us take in secondary cell. Next example taken is nickel cadmium battery. This battery again like other primary secondary cells is rechargeable. ये प्रॉपर्टी होता है सेकेंडरी सेल्स का कि देयर रिचार्जेबल. इसका यूज कहां पर होता है? देखिए इसका यूज कहां होता है? मेनली इन कैमरास कैलकुलेटर देयर यूज नाउ मोर कॉमनली. तो देयर यूज स्पेशली कैमरास कैलकुलेटर्स. इसका एडवांटेज क्या है? देयर लॉन्गर लाइफ एज कंपेयर टू लेड स्टोरेज बैटरी बट देयर मोर एक्सपेंसिव. देयर मोर एक्सपेंसिव बट देयर लॉन्गर लाइफ एज कंपेयर टू योर लेड स्टोरेज बैटरी. इसका इसमें एनोड क्या होता है? कैडमियम इन द केस इलेक्ट्रोड इज एक्टिंग एज एनोड. कैडमियम इलेक्ट्रोड इज एक्टिंग एज एनोड एंड दिस कैथोड इज मेटल ग्रेड. ए मेटल ग्रेड कंटेनिंग निकल डाइऑक्साइड NiO2. Ni4 ऑक्साइड इज कैथोड. NiO2 सपोर्टिंग बाय द मेटल ग्रेड दैट इज एक्टिंग एज कैथोड एंड इट इज इमर्स इन सोल्यूशन ऑफ KOH. KOH सोल्यूशन इज एक्टिंग एज इलेक्ट्रोलाइट. Concentrated solution of KOH is acting as electrolyte. What is reactions at anode? At anode, oxidation reaction occur of cadmium to give cadmium hydroxide in OH presence, giving electrons. At cathode, reduction reaction occur of nickel plus 4 to give nickel plus 2 state. Redox reaction will be spontaneous, involving 2 electrons. If I had net reaction taken here, a net reaction can take here 2 OH and will cancel out in the net reaction. We can add net reaction cadmium solid plus NiO2 solid plus 2H2O giving CdOH whole twice solid plus nickel hydroxide solid. It is the net reaction in the given nickel cadmium battery. Net reaction, see, the net reaction does not involve any gas. The net reaction does not involve any gas. So such batteries can be sealed. So this battery can be sealed because the reaction involved no gas evolution in the reaction. So such batteries can be sealed easily. Then this battery can provide a voltage around 1.4 in the life. This will produce a voltage around 1.4 volt. This can produce a voltage or potential around 1.4 volt. Now in this reaction you can again see the, like we have discussed in last lead storage battery also, that cadmium hydroxide or nickel hydroxide are produced at anode and cathode. If you take the lead storage battery, we get lead sulfate formation at anode and cathode both electrodes, and lead sulfate was adsorbed adhered on the electrode respectively. Same thing also happens here, that cadmium hydroxide will adhere, stick on the cadmium electrodes, and nickel hydroxide will adhere on the metal grid containing nickel oxide, nickel 4 oxide. So what happens? This make them to change the direction of reaction at any time, at the requirement. Remember, we have discussed in previous case, I'm again repeating in this cell also, they produce some substances, solids, which are adhered, adsorbed and take on the electrodes, so that on recharging, the reaction direction can be reversed spontaneously, easily. ये requirement होता है इसका, ठीक है? तो आपका ये हुआ, तो इसका ये हुआ advantage कि that they will have longer life, rechargeable भी आपके होते हैं, तो that better than we can take primary cells, special dry cells. इसका main drawback क्या होता है? Cadmium, poisonous nature, disposal problem. Cadmium being poisonous nature, तो problem will be arising disposal of cadmium in the reaction, which is there. Okay, so anyway, it is the working of nickel cadmium battery. I hope आपको समझ में आया होगा. आपको क्या याद करना है? इतनी सारी रिएक्शन हो रही है, आपको मेनली रिएक्शन ध्यान रखना है और उसका की पॉइंट्स. डायग्राम आपको स्पेशली अगर पता है तो अच्छी बात है, नहीं डायग्राम बहुत नहीं पूछते हैं. आप डायग्राम आपको जो मैंने ड्रॉ किया है वही डायग्राम ध्यान रख लीजिए. कौन से ड्राई सेल का डायग्राम देख लिया? वन कैन टेक फॉर द लेड स्टोरेज बैटरी डायग्राम था, वो देख लीजिए. पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू से होते हैं. और बाकी आपको रिएक्शन लेकिन पता होना चाहिए, एनोड पे कौन सा रिएक्शन है, कैथोड पे क्या रिएक्शन है, बैटरी का क्या एडवांटेज है और क्या ड्रॉबैक है बैटरीज का. ये आपके लिए इंपॉर्टेंट स्पेशली होगा, ठीक है? तो अब हमारा नेक्स्ट एग्जाम्पल आता है इसमें फ्यूल सेल्स. ओके, तो लेट अस टेक नेक्स्ट टॉपिक फ्यूल सेल. सो लेट अस टेक अवर नेक्स्ट टॉपिक टेकन फ्यूल सेल्स. इन फ्यूल सेल्स व्हाट हैपन, द एंथैल्पी ऑफ कंबस्शन will directly convert into electrical energy. In the fuel cell, the enthalpy of combustion, combustion of which fuels? Hydrogen, CO, CH4, CH3OH, etc. Different fuels are there. When they undergo combustion, what is combustion reactions? Redox reactions. Combustion reactions are example of redox reactions. They involve electrons exchange. They involve electrons exchange. So when we take combustion reactions involving redox reactions, they will, that redox reaction we, which is involving electrons, that redox reaction which become spontaneous, we are using for generation of the electrical current, electrical energy. So that happens in the fuel cells. They convert the enthalpy of combustion directly into electrical energy. Now we can have different fuel cells. Among that, our fuel cell which we have to study is H2O2 fuel cell. We will study here fuel cell, H2O2 fuel cell. In this H2O2 fuel cell, it is a rough diagram drawn here. We are having anode made of porous carbon containing suitable catalyst like palladium, platinum, etc. Cathode also of porous carbon, same hota hai. Cathode also made of porous carbon containing suitable catalyst, palladium, platinum, space कम है, कम है, ऐसे लिखा नहीं मैंने वहां पर है. यहाँ पे कैथोड से होता है, कैथोड इज ऑल्सो मेड ऑफ पोरस कार्बन कंटेनिंग सुइटेबल कैटलिस्ट प्लेटिनम पैलेडियम सिल्वर एटसेट्रा, दे कैन बी देयर. एंड इट इज पोरस इलेक्ट्रोड्स थ्रू विच द गैस आर डिफ्यूज्ड. एंड देन वी टेक कंसेंट्रेटेड सॉल्यूशन ऑफ KOH और NaOH इज यूज्ड एज इलेक्ट्रोलाइट. Concentrated KOH or NaOH is used as electrolyte. When reaction take place, what happen? They will form water. Sorry, water is produced in the reaction. So what happen in the given case? When reactions are taken, we are supplying fuel. What is fuel? Hydrogen and oxygen continuously. In this case, the fuel supply should be continuous. From one side we are putting hydrogen, second side introducing oxygen through porous carbon. They will be diffusing into the KOH and then reaction take place. At anode, you know, common oxidation reaction occur. Hydrogen oxidized to the water and electron liberation at anode, oxidation reaction. oxidation reaction occur at anode. At cathode, reduction reaction take place. At cathode, reduction reaction take place where O2 plus H2O give A plus electron form OH negative ion. If you write net reaction, just combine both. If you write the net reaction, gap paigar 2H2 gas plus O2 gas. Water hai pe kitna hai 4 ya 2 hai to 2 will cancel. OH will cancel out. Electrons also will cancel out. Will give 2H2O liquid. Give 2H2O liquid. This fuel cells, they are used in spacecraft. Why? Because they produce water which can be used for drinking purpose by the astronauts. The Apollo mission which went to moon, they have used this fuel cell which was providing water as the byproduct. The weight of the fuel cell is around 200 kg which were used there. And if you remember Apollo 13, which was blasted because of only fuel cell blast, that caused accident. Apollo 13 spacecraft was blasted for that reason. Anyway, let's come on the reaction base. This fuel cells, they will have reactions already are clear to you. Spacecraft na use hota hai, special ka use hota hai applications. Aur iska ye hydrogen aur O2 apka example liya tha humne yahan fuel cell ka. Oxidation upper redox reaction over. In this redox reaction they convert, they will produce energy, heat energy. That heat energy will convert to electrical energy directly. Ab isme kya hota hai, iska advantage kya hai batteries ke, dekhiye. This battery is never dead. Kyun? The fuels are supplied regularly and that too they convert to water which keep on separating out. So this battery will have long, we can take, will never dead. It can produce electric energy as long as we keep on supplying the fuels for combustion reaction. They can produce a voltage of around 0.9 volt continuously. They can produce a voltage around 0.9 volt. That is the voltage produced by the given cells. And they maintain, they require temperature to be kept around 70 to 140 degrees Celsius. And definitely high pressure required to store the gases. So that's the problem also. The main issues are drawback of the batteries are there to store the hydrogen gas or the O2 gases at low pressure. Sorry, at high pressure in this condition of temperature, that is problematic in using fuel cells. Anyway, agla kehta hai, for the fuel cells, sometimes we have questions for calculation of efficiency of fuel cells, written percentage. Efficiency of fuel cells can be given by delta G of combustion by delta H out of combustion into 100. If you take for water production, delta G is given minus 237.39 kilojoule per mole, and delta H of combustion of water given around minus 285.7 kilojoule per mole into 100. That gives the fuel efficiency around 83%. Meaning, to this extent, the heat and the energy of combustion will convert to free energy, that is electrical energy. Abhinandan, delta U naught is minus NFE naught is electrical work done. So, in this case, when they ask some time question of calculation of fuel cells percentage efficiency, so it is around 83% in this case. But in general, the fuel cells have efficiency around 60 to 70% in most cases. Okay, if you take the thermal power plant, they will have maximum fuel efficiency only around 40%. Because already I discussed in combustion, pehle kya hoga? Combustion hua coal ka, CO2 gas banta hai. Us combustion mein heat evolve hoga. Jo heat evolve hota hai, usse kya hota hai? They will evaporate water to form steam. That steam will help in rotation of turbines and then they can generate electrical energy. Lot of wastage normally happens there. So they have lower fuel efficiency. We are trying to use these cells in future, especially in future hydrogen economy. Dekhiye, aapko pata hai ki right now we are using fossil fuels, petrol, diesel, or gases, LPG or other gases, they are not everlasting. It is well known to all of us, they are not everlasting. कभी तो खत्म होना ही है. जब खत्म होंगे तो क्या होगा, फिर फ्यूल कहां से लाएंगे? और अगला रीजन क्या है, जो हमारे फ्यूल हम यूज करते हैं, पेट्रोलियम, डीजल और एलपीजी और अदर गैसेस, उनमें क्या होता है, दे इवॉल्व गैसेस, CO2 गैसेस, तो दे विल कॉज ग्रीन हाउस इफेक्ट, पॉल्यूशन एट लार्ज स्केल, दैट कैन डेवलप इन ओजोन डिप्लीशन, आल्सो कॉज बाय दिस ग्रीन हाउस इफेक्ट, ग्रीन हाउस गैसेस इफेक्ट. सो व्हाट हैपेंड, दे आर कॉजिंग पॉल्यूशन हजार्ड्स यूजिंग द फॉसिल फ्यूल्स. यहां पर क्या है, सेफ है. उस एंगल से क्या बनता है, वाटर वी कैन यूज फॉर ड्रिंकिंग पर्पज एज वेल. ओनली प्रॉब्लम इज हैंडलिंग एंड यूजिंग देम ऑन कमर्शियल स्केल सो दैट दे कैन बी यूज इवन फॉर अदर पर्पज. तो ट्रायल्स आर गोइंग ऑन इफ वी कैन यूज दिस इन फ्यूचर. फ्यूल फ्यूल सेल्स फॉर जनरेशन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिकल एनर्जी, दे आर हाईली एफिशियंट, नॉन पॉल्यूटिंग, हाईली एफिशियंट, सी द एफिशियंसी, एंड नॉन पॉल्यूटिंग फ्यूल सेल्स. What is the drawbacks? Drawbacks are technical problems. इसमें क्या है, गैस, if you take three phases, गैस, हाइड्रोजन, O2 गैस, solids, कार्बन electrodes, and solutions, liquids, are to be in contact simultaneously. तो again, technical issues are coming to bring all three in contact same time. Then maintenance of the gas at maintaining the gases at high pressure again is problematic. To store the gases at high pressure again is problematic in the given case. And they are quite expensive. They are using catalyst, platinum, palladium, silver, which are being high cost. Due to high cost of the catalyst, commercially they are not they are becoming expensive. They become commercially expensive. And one drawback more can be taken, nature of electrolyte. What is electrolyte? KOH or NaOH, high concentration taken of NaOH or KOH, they are corrosive in action. By corrosive nature, they again are difficult to handle. So there are some drawbacks and the application of fuel cells. So anyway, it is our topic, the batteries or cells which we are completing now. Okay. So it is about the functioning and working of batteries. Next topic we can take is corrosion, and we take then conductance. Okay, next topic we will take is corrosion in next topic, next class.